This doesn't feel like iRacing. Like, this is classic cars in iRacing. Like, sometimes forget that they have them.
No, the classic cars is just crazy.
There's so much good content in iRacing though on races.
Yeah, like GTEs.
Craig, I said there's so many good cars in iRacing. Well, here we go. First ever racing camp.
Go well.
8-lap race here at the Nordschleife. This is going to be interesting. It is multi-class as well. I'm not sure how long it'll be before we hit the Audis, but should be fun nonetheless. I'm not completely comfortable in the car yet, but we'll try our best. We'll try not to commit crashing. Just going to try and stay alive, make it to the finish, take any positions that do come our way, but Group C cars at Nordschleife aren't the best for side-by-side action.
Stay focused. Pace car is off.
And here we go. Green, 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 and there's a silk cut Jag livery in our mirrors. That's slightly cursed. Try and make it through. Oh, everybody.
Three
wide. That does not build more confidence. We clear? We're clear. We're up to P2, boys. Not going to stay here, though. John looks mighty fast up ahead. He's going to try and pull away from the fake Jaguar behind. Schumacher S is almost flat, definitely not on the first lap on cold tyres though. God, John's quick. Ooh, got to be careful on the downshift, try not to blow the engine like I did in practice. Already starting to... yeah, that's exactly it, Jackson. This car sticks to the pace of whoever has the biggest pair between their legs. Unfortunately, I don't have that.
You don't have a pair between your legs?
Not big enough ones to get this car on pace, no. Oh, that was a bit of an overshoot. Maxime, don't do it here. Oh, Maxime wants his position. Run away. Blue flat's almost flat. Oh, Maxime had a bit of a wiggle behind. Right, come on, John's 1.5 seconds up the road already. Man knows how to drive. With a kink, completely flat. Carl's wiggling around all over the place. On the brakes into the corner, I can never remember the name of, but I do know.
Stopped in the middle of the track, not moving, and you guys are in right there, fucked into me. Really?
Oh. Chris is dead.
From my perspective, it looks like you rolled back onto the track.
Already 7 kilometers into the first lap. Ho-ho.
That's why we hit.
That's where I blew the engine in practice. Let's get through it. This time unscathed. Miss, keep it in fourth gear, try and fight off the understeer, but don't let it go and snap oversteer. Down to the hairpin. Oh, that was a lot of curb. that corner. Such a tricky one to get through.
Now, if I just watch the replay, I'm sitting there in the track with my brakes on, you guys just plow into me.
No, man, you are moving backwards.
Oh, Maxime's at the run. We're gonna stick to the left.
See, after you hit the barrier in the front, you just go back to the track.
Oh, Maxime's backed out of it. Either that or we have more top. I think we might have more top speed. I think we might be running less downforce. We could play a lot. Even in the slipstream, struggling to catch.
Can't afford a parked car, a wrecked car.
Big lift there through bravery.
I mean,
and the big lift here through the right hander as well.
I'd advise you to calm down, and let's just all get on with it.
You can mute me if you don't want to hear me.
All right.
Is he going to try to run the outside of me at the carousel? That ain't going to work.
No, at least you get the message.
Not yet, Maxime, not yet. Save it for the Bossinger.
I'm allowed to voice my frustration just like everyone else here. All I'm asking is there's a parked car in the fucking track. Use your brakes and swerve it. Don't just plow into it. That's it.
Don't smack that curb. You can't use it. Yeah, Maxime's got to be running more down for us.
But it's you that wasn't supposed to be there.
Too much. Gaining on the straights here. Down the corner, sorry.
That's the accident.
Oh no!
Another
accident.
By just plowing into me.
Clear.
Didn't even slow down. Go back and watch the replay. The conversation's over.
Yes, please shut up, Chris. You're very distracting. Right, now we get a chance to see what sort of downforce Maxime's running. Whether we absolutely storm by on the back straight. Oh! I don't know if that was a lockup or an engine blowout. Oh, John's blown his engine!
Go right.
The fuck?
John blew his engine in the second carousel. Putting right, so us back up to P2. Now we've got Maxime to go and try and catch. Come on. Come on.
You have about 5 laps of fuel left.
The gains, I know. Really nice start. We just managed to stay out of trouble. Oh, Maxime's binned it. P1, baby.
Okay, you are the leader.
Now it's just a case of trying to stay ahead of the guys behind. And not crashing the car. Not sure what Hubert's pace is like. Oh, who's that connected?
Just focus on the race.
Probably Schumacher S is almost flat in this car. Hubert is faster, I think. Gained about half a second on me in that first sector. And then we managed to pull it back again, no throw for two flats. Turn in, please. That wasn't fourth yet. Curse lock up hours. Mine and Hubert's pace is about the same. Gap staying roughly around that 66.5 second mark. Might be damaged though, look at the gap we're filling on the straight. Either that or, again, more wing. No, he's definitely got some sort of straight line damage. Gained a second on him just up the hill alone.
Yeah, he's got damage.
Oh, he has?
Yeah, just a little bit on the front.
What about Maxime? How much did he get damage from that incident to the wall? Maxime can probably make the move on Hubert this lap.
No idea.
Faster than me at the start of the race anyway. Breathe for 5 seconds.
You're right, by the way. Maxime did make the move.
I thought he might. He'll be coming to me then. So much quicker on the actual Nordschleifer, even with damage.
You had. Oh no, they both crashed!
They've both crashed?
No, they haven't. No, they haven't. My relative has gone crazy. You actually have speed over them on the straight.
On the straight, yeah, but through the corners. I'm pretty sure Maxime's running more downforce than me anyway. But he's going to make that time up in the corners very quickly. Gappy pulled even on the tiniest sector. He was ahead. Crew chiefing for me, Craig, or are you just spectating?
I am indeed in the crew chief position.
Okay. Do you know how much fuel I need, then?
No.
Okay.
I don't have a crew chief loaded, and I wouldn't have a fair representation.
My fuel calculator is telling me in litres. Which is very helpful.
How many litres?
I don't know, but you have to... It's in kilograms, the car.
Yep, I was going to do a conversion.
Oh, I'll tell you on the corner. 38 litres. I think it's, it should be, I think, around 31 kilos. That's what I've got it set to at the moment. That's the second lap I've done that there. No!
You're fine.
Fuck's sake. Second lap in a row I've done that there.
Car on your left.
Yeah, but you're still clear. Standing.
I think I didn't pick any damage up from that.
Nah. You already got a little bit scraping from the curves like everybody else, so.
That's fine. Chase is on then.
Problem is, I can tell you what the weight is, but like the weight of fuel is different to water.
I'm gonna trust what I said and read in Discord then and go 31 kilos.
Well, you put 32, but yeah.
Yeah, roughly about that. About the end of lap 4. So I do 4 laps, hit, and then do another 4 laps basically. Swap tyres as well at the stop. Gets the best out of both sets of tyres then. corner always scares me. That left hander there.
You're doing fine.
Both the guys ahead have some top speed damage, but they're just quicker than me.
Oh god, you're 15 kilometers faster than them.
I'm not surprised Maxim had a big hit into the barrier. I honestly thought that would be him out. Base top speed, yes.
7 minutes 29.285. You got 5 laps to go.
This is the lap you come in, isn't it?
Indeed.
So you start with 90 kilograms, don't you?
90?
Yeah,
your
fuel tank is 90. Remaining is 45.9 kilograms.
You can work all that out as a lap. I can't, I'm a bit preoccupied. Last night is 45, so I've used half the tank in 3 laps. So it's 15 kilos a lap, basically.
Yeah.
And I'll have 30 kilos left in the tank when I hit. So yeah, 31 should be enough. Maybe go 33 to be safe. Whoa!
Just keep focusing.
Oh, nice how much the car moves around there. Ooh. Toge run hours. Love this music. My question is, will I be able to do the hairpin this time? We made it!
Gave you a bit more space this time, didn't you?
That and I didn't look up. flirty with his downshifts. Oh god. Right, here comes the gaining time. Oh, look how much we're gaining. Oh, that's gaining too much though. There's an Audi.
Yep, and it's damaged.
God, they spit flame. It's going to be interesting.
He might take it easy as well.
Historic motorclass, that's a new one. Should I be expecting any more traffic soon?
No.
Okay, that's fine. Whoa!
Off the curbs.
Off the curbs, you idiot. It's not a GT3 car.
You sticking with 32 kilograms, yeah?
Yep. Tires are checked, yeah?
Tires are ticked.
There's 2 left of fuel left. You'll need to stop for more fuel.
You might get in a slipstream at the end, but you might also be pitting at the same time.
I'm not sure if he'll pit. I think Maxime will.
Which I'll let you know. It's coming over to Tiergarten now. Pitting.
I'm taking the traditional strategy then.
Box, box, box.
We missed the pit line. Oh shit, there's no pit limiter, is there?
Oh, there isn't?
Car doesn't have a pit limiter, no.
Might hit traffic.
Ah, oh, shit.
What damage?
1.1 optionals.
A whole minute? I'm joking. Yep, grief.
Need a drink quickly.
Okay, go.
Oh yeah, you got 4.7. You'll be fine. 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. You'll be fine.
So we're easy on fuel then?
Yeah. Guy in front just had a slow lap, but he has done 29s and 27s, so in theory you shouldn't be catching him.
really feel the fresh tyres. And the cold tyres as well.
You don't want to know the tyre percentages.
Were they fairly low?
Hey, your ears weren't bad. 83, 84.
That's not bad.
There's 75, 77 on fronts.
That's not bad, to be fair. I think there'd be double stintable, but I don't know. I'm pretty sure you could get in a quad stint these break.
Still waiting for that tag.
The tyre whisperer.
Yeah.
Mitchell, give him the roll. Give him the Discord roll of tyre whisperer. Oh, this is going to be interesting. Not sure what the closing speed is like. I'm not doing that. Line, you taking Audi?
Left side.
Clear. Clear.
Tyre Whisperer or Michelin's best friend? Which would you prefer, Craig?
Tyre Whisperer. Being a Tyre Whisperer. Only being Michelin's only IMSA.
Ooh, that's a line.
You did hit the curb going into compression.
Two in a row. Oh, Henlo, sir, I didn't even notice you there. Try third gear. About the same as second. Bring at the rotation, you get better traction. You are blessed by the camel, yes. Real chirpy boy hours. The curbs are tall.
You gotta work together, man. You can't just do that.
Come on, get into gear.
The lead is spinning now.
The leader in the pits.
Correct. You got this guy anyway, he probably knows.
As long as he doesn't try and come back at me.
Car on your left.
I mean, that wing is
still
fucked.
There, hold your line.
Back.
Clear.
I mean, surely he'll have to fit this lap anyway.
Pits.
1.965. The next car's the leader.
Gonna have enough pressure tires in us. But look how much we've gained just by not tires are free.
Take them.
He didn't take them. But the tyres are free and
his car never went on the jacks.
The tyres are free during the fuel stop.
His car never went on the jacks.
Oh. Well, sucks for him. But look how much I've gained. I was 12 seconds behind him when I went to the pits. How much longer that's taken on the fuel, despite the fact that I appeared before him and taking tires.
I don't know. Unfortunately, I was still getting my overlay sorted, and I didn't have the pit timer.
If he hasn't taken tires, that's nice to see. Every lap. Over there, he took the repairs he had. From the back into the wall.
Yeah, he did.
Okay. Who was the other car we were fighting with earlier? It was the...
Cuba,
oh, it was Hubert, wasn't it?
Yeah, he's 18 seconds behind you.
Behind?
Yeah.
Gone for a very long pit stop then. So at the moment I'm net P2, I think.
Correct.
With Maxime the net leader.
And again. Correct.
Martin's yet to pit. Cool. Okay. It'll be the next lap where we start to see how Maxime's tyres are.
You've got a GTO in front as well.
Car right. Clear.
Ordinarily, I would say, please don't do that, but honestly, I didn't mind. He made it clear
actually,
he was going to let him pass.
Where else was he going to let him?
Yeah.
You know,
he made it very clear he was doing that. I feel like he'd done it last second. Thank you very much, Juan. up there. Oh Christ, what are you doing, Audi? Which side are you taking? No damage?
He just caused the other... No, you're fine.
That was a core X.
I'll check. The guy behind just ate shit as well because of that guy. He got a little bit of nose damage, but not big. I just sent him a message, you need to pick a line. He did not pick a line there.
Howard
behind us, at the corner after Bravery, he had no idea where the guy was going, including you, and just hit the brakes, hit the grass on brakes. That GTO just, almost caught the big one.
Car on your left, clear.
God, we are accelerating them like crazy.
It's scary, mate.
Like, just stick your foot down in this car and it just disappears.
By the way, Maxine overtook Martin.
Oh yeah, I see. And those Audis are four-wheel drive. I think.
Pass, I haven't looked.
My slow motorsport knowledge is correct, which probably isn't. Maxime just been given a massive gap by that Audi of Bravery. He managed to get past the fourth corner and who knows what he was doing. Somewhere there was a gear.
Well, this guy in front's got a pit.
Has to, yeah. God, that corner is horrible in this car. So is this one. Right, now we see how Maxime's tyres have held up. Two laps to go. If he didn't take tyres, which I'm not sure why. What wheel do I have? I have a Thrustmaster TX with the, it's the leather edition. It's a TM28 leather edition or something. Dives into the pit.
Two left to go. Two to go.
I'm on 7 seconds. Maxine, your tyres must be dead.
3.11. You're back in second.
Maxine's gone up ahead. Watch out, he's in the middle of the track.
Go right.
damage, or just spun?
Spun did hit the wall, but I don't think massively. Nah, there's no.
No damage then.
Just spun. Yeah. Yeah.
He'll be after me then. With whatever tyres he's got left, he'll be after me.
He did hit the wall, but it wasn't hard enough, really. Just keep focused.
Turn, please. My team is so quick. On the straights, I think I'm quicker.
You are 10 kilometers.
No. I still think Maxine's running more downforce though, even before any damage. She can keep up with me in a slipstream. She or he, I don't know, is Maxine a girl's turn?
Maxine's the same name for the guy, French guy who does the Apex sets.
Yeah. Just associate Maxine being a girl's name. Whatever they are, they're fucking fast. That's scary.
Yeah, Maxine's actually a male name.
Okay. I just lack so much confidence in that final sector there. Like, you get all the S's, and then it sort of as you come through the roller coaster section. It's towards the second carousel. That sector, I just lack so much confidence.
You're doing fine. Just a heads up, you will meet P1 and P2 in the GTOs.
About 40 seconds up the road. Yeah, I see him in the relative. Set myself up to go to a right hander then.
I need one more good lap. You are the leader. Nice and
where's Maxime gone?
I don't know. Have a look. Fuel
he dropped off a relative.
Yeah. Lost on the apex of Sabina Smith curve.
Damage?
No.
Did he do it me? Lock
he,
up.
He lost it. He no curve again.
Oh. Space.
Car on your left.
Yeah,
clear,
that was
the
a wise
left
move to do.
I had time there, that was...
I thought you were already on this straight, I forgot about that.
Sometimes when you get confused between which of the two little right-handers leads onto the big straight.
wait.
Going to the left then, and he went back to the middle of the road. Oh well, we're past.
Right, eyes down. Punch it, Chewie.
You're not wrong, here's a fucking hyperspace button for us all. Not top speed wise, it doesn't have that much in the shape of top speed, doesn't it? 200 miles an hour. I know I'm damaged, but even normally I'd only hit about 300k. But out of the corner, it's just instant.
P1,
come
baby.
On!
That's a P1, baby!
Whoa! Come on!
That's a drive!
Yeah, did it. Too bad it wasn't for a million.
Holy shit! Great race, Maxime. Kept me on my toes the whole race. Sorry?
That was on all teams, not drivers. Brave.
My right hand is literally...
Good race, Christian, that was fun.
Like, locked. Then she spent half that race one-handed.
And your gear stick's on the left, is it?
Yeah.
I know what you're going to be doing with that right hand tonight, putting it in a bucket of ice. Get your head out the gutter.
I mean, I'm left-handed, so that's not a problem. But wow! God, this car is fucking amazing. Why is this the least popular series in iRacing? I do not know.
GT1s want a word with you.
Yeah, Grand Prix Legends. I forgot about those 50s cars, 60s cars even. Oh, just pick up another off track for good measure.
Hang on 1 second. We should have done this.
Anthony Maynard, you are a winner!
No, no, it doesn't have the same ring to it. So you want to paint livery? You want to paint for this now, don't you? Okay, fuck you. That looked like you were enjoying it. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh,
I
was thoroughly enjoying that. That was just what I needed. Don't get me wrong, racing IMSA and the P2 is amazing, and doing the Enduros is amazing. But driving that where it's so wild, and you have, I mean, I have not concentrated that much. Like, with the P2, you can get away with a 5 minutes, or a 5 seconds of relaxing, I should say. In that car, you cannot relax. Oh, wow. Oh. Oh.